Looking like a good night for baseball in Cincinnati. Indians baseball now. Sun's starting to set now over Great American Ballpark in Cincinnati. Tonight, it's Interleague Baseball, the first of a two-game set between the Indians and their in-state rivals to the south, the Cincinnati Reds. Here with another edition of Indians Baseball, I'm Matt Vasgersian. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, a good matchup on the mound here in this opener.
And of course, we're going to see a guy that's definitely in Cy Young contention this season. You see the numbers coming in. 18 wins on the year so far. So that'll be a storyline going forward. Can he get himself one step closer to 20 wins?
More from the guys as this one goes along. But first, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Cleveland Indians as they'll align themselves like this here tonight. Tony Cingrani gets the ball to face them, and I think the one key will be how aggressive he is on the mound. He's got to get the ball and go right after hitters because he can get into trouble when he nitpicks and falls behind. And defensively, you see the Reds line up like this behind him. Michael Brantley makes his way to the plate now as we're just about set for baseball this evening. First pitch of the night is over for strike one as we get started right on time at 7:10 p.m. EK, let's take a look at our homestanding nine as they enter play here this evening. It was another loss last time out, and this portion of the schedule has not done them any favors as they've dropped five of their last seven.
Yeah, and this game's not always that hard. You hit the ball, you throw the ball, you catch the ball, but lately they haven't been doing any of the three particularly well. That's going to need to change, and soon.
Carlos Santana will stand in, back in the lineup after getting the night off yesterday. Now here's the first pitch. And this ball swung on and hit on the ground. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning.
Well, that's how you want to start a ball game. Three pitches and two outs. He's not even loose yet, but he's almost through the first inning.
Jason Kipnis will stand in. He comes off an 0 for 4 in last night's ball game. First pitch on the way. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one.
Yeah, those are the ones you like to start in that bat, especially your first time up.
I agree. Give me a nice easy one in the dirt that I can take so I can really get ahead in that count early.
Here comes the 1-0. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. You got to figure that that man right there would be more than happy to see this guy at the plate taking his swings with two out and nobody on all night long.
So would the guy on the mound.
Here's the 1-1. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2.
Very patient here to start the at-bat. Maybe even a little too patient because now he's down 1-2.
Yeah, and I don't think he's going to get anything better than that to hit.
Here comes the 1-2. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Here's another 1-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here he comes again, 1-2. Fouled back. Now another 1-2. swing and a miss on the breaking ball, and he sets him down for out number three. Down in order go the Tribe. And now the Reds will get their first opportunity. No score. Now the starting lineup for Cincinnati in this one. Corey Kluber is on the mound here to face these guys. He's got the usual assortment of pitches, but keep an eye on him in the early going here. If these guys can get to him early, he does have a tendency to start overthrowing. And from there, that's when the problems usually arise. Defensively, the Indians will line up this way. Brandon Phillips will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
Leading off for the Reds, number four, second baseman, Brandon Phillips.
Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. And the pitch. And this one misses to Phillips. It's a ball and a strike. EK, you take a look at our visitors as they enter play here this evening. All you can really say is they've been on one heck of a run.
Yeah, I mean, they're looking like world beaters right now. I don't care what league you're in. Anytime you can put together a double-digit win streak like these guys have put together, you're playing some great baseball.
Ready with the 2-1. Now a swing and a hard-hit ball to short. And the Velas will throw on to first, and there's one gone.
Batting second, the shortstop, Zach Cozart.
Zach Cozart will get his first opportunity now. And as you see there, he's in need of something to go his way because he's been ice cold these past eight ball games. Now here's the first pitch. Here's a curveball that runs outside. It's ball one. Now, how important is it going to be for this guy to throw that curveball for strikes?
I don't know that he necessarily needs to ever throw it for a strike. I mean, if it's around the plate and he's getting guys to go after it, it's doing its job. But if he starts to get too high or too far outside, then it's just an easy take.
2-0 on the way. And a sinker is over that time. It's back to 2-1. Figure we'll probably see a heavy dose of that sinker here tonight.
It's really a pitch you'll lean on, especially when he needs that ground ball. But even in situations like this where he's just trying to get ahead.
Now a swing and a miss at the hard sinker, and they're back to even 2-2. Here it comes. Fouled back. Ready with another 2-2. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. There's Joey Votto as he gets ready in the on-deck circle. Full count pitch on its way. Oh, and he lets him off the hook there as this isn't even close for ball four.
That's an easy take right there on the 3-2 pitch. Not all that inviting at all. You want to at least make the guy think about hacking up there. Instead, now he's on with one away.
Joey Votto will stand in now as the National League's leading hitter entering play. Here's the first offering. Runner goes for second. Fouled toward the third base dugout, but this will get back into the seats out of play. He waits. Now the pitch. Now here's the ball hit sharply toward the right side. And Votto reaches. He's got a base hit. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
Well, here's a manager showing early on that he's not going to play it close to the vest. They put the runner in motion, and this is the perfect hit and run. Now there's runners on the corners, and they're in a good spot to drive in the game's first run.
Jay Bruce will stand in here. Currently sixth in the National League in RBIs, but with a good chance to pad that total here. Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one.
Well, this is the kind of situation where they came up short last night. They had opportunities, but they could never really cash them in. So you can bet they'd love to get something going on the board early here.
Pause. Now the pitch. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. But a foul ball. One and one. One one on the way. On the ground for Kipnis. This could be two. To second for one. The relay on to first. The double play, and the side is retired.
Boy, oh boy.
4-6-3. They roll it up to get out of the jam. We're off to the second, scoreless on the show. Nick Swisher will get his first shot here, and he certainly had it working so far this season, up over 350 entering play. First pitch coming. There's a line drive, and he's swinging it as good as anyone, folks. The streak will continue. He's got a base hit. So a base hit here to start the inning, and he continues to pile them up as we take a look at our league leaders in hits so far. And as you can see there, he currently leads the AL in that department. Brandon Moss will dig in for the first time as he'll enter play sixth in the American League in hitting. First pitch coming. Good slider there, and he gets ahead of him, nothing and one. Here comes the pitch to Moss. And that swung on and fouled straight back. He's ready now. The pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Oh, and that's a sweet pitch right there. You know, on the mound, there's very few things that can happen negatively with this location. I mean, you're either going to swing and miss, you foul it off, or you hit it into the ground where it becomes a double play. But I'm sure on the mound, you'll take the strikeout.
Yan Gomes will stride in now. And as you can see, he's currently sixth in the American League in home runs. Here's the first offering. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground is short. Phillips for one. On to Votto, a double play, and that ends the inning. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two, and we are tied 0-0. Chris Heisey will stride in now. Two hits for him, including a home run in last night's contest. First pitch coming. And, oh, looked inside, but that's ruled a strike, 0-1.
Well,
he's been in a tough stretch offensively, and this sure ain't gonna help.
Now the pitch. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Ready now on 1-1. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. 1-2 now. Here comes a 1-2. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out.
Yeah, he essentially tripled up there. That means he threw the same pitch one, two, three times in a row. You don't see that very often, but it's going to work out for him as he gets the strikeout.
Here's Todd Frazier now. As Kluber's able to get ahead of him here with strike one. He comes in with that average down in the 240s. 10 home runs and 49 runs batted in. Bottom of the second here with no score. Now the pitch. And here's a sinker that had a little bit too much dart to it there as it just about came in and nailed him.
I think it's pretty simple. The message here is stop leaning out over the plate. You know, pitcher's got to be able to work inside, so that's just a reminder there.
1-1 pitch on the way. And here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now.
And after you move a guy off the plate and you know he's all worked up, that's a perfect time to drop a curveball or a changeup on him. Great pitch call right there.
The right-hander deals on 1-2. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. He'll try again, 1-2. Roasted into left field. That's a base hit.
Batting seventh, center fielder.
Let's check out the sequence of pitches here. 0-1, he gets ahead. Next one misses. Then a swinging strike two puts him in the hole. Bites off the fourth pitch foul, gets another chance, and boom, connects on pitch number five for a solid base hit.
Ryan Ludwig will get his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. And here's the first pitch. A called strike to the 35-year-old veteran. Nothing and one.
Tonight, borderline calls, you got to be swinging.
Come set, now the pitch. Pitch too high, and that's over the catcher's head. And he'll make it in easily at second, as I'd imagine that'll be scored a passed ball.
Yeah, you know, sometimes that late movement on a cut fastball is just a little too hot to handle, and you can see it right there. It just kicks off the end of his glove, and that's going to be ruled a passed ball.
The 1-1. I think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two.
Yeah, that pitch is still up a little bit, but at least this one was out on a corner. But I don't think I'd want to be making a living up there too much.
Now the 1-2. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Here's another 1-2. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact. One out and a runner on second base. 2-2. Swing and a ball hit on the ground. But a foul ball as it holds at 2-2. A 2-2 one more time. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. You have to figure that he's really going to need to keep the walks in check if he's going to have success here.
I was thinking the same thing. No free rides. You've got to make these guys earn it.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
let's analyze this swing on swing track. This pitch is away, but you'll see him swing inside the ball to try to pull it. You got to take that the other way.
Stepping in now, Brian Peña. Yes, he'll take a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He'll enter play here with that average down in the low 200s. 5 homers and 22 RBIs. He's set. Now the pitch. Now he sends a routine fly ball out to straightaway center. Brantley is under it, and he makes the catch for out number 3. One left for Cincinnati. We'll move to the third with no score. Ryan Rayburn will lead things off. Bottom third of the order set to go here in the third.
Number 11, Ryan Rayburn.
First offering on the way. He swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. Ludwig is under it as he puts it away, and it's one pitch, one away to start the third.
Boy, they are just making life easy for this guy. Swinging on the first pitch of the inning, pretty routine fly ball. It's been a cakewalk here early on.
Mike Aviles will get his first opportunity now, and as you can see, he enters play with that average up near the 320 mark. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1. Now here it comes. And Aviles will watch this one miss, and it evens the count at 1-1. Third inning, no score to this point. The 1-1. And a half swing here, but he pretty clearly went around, and it's 1-2 now. Here's the 1-2. And this is going to be a foul ball. Another 1-2 delivery. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike 3.
And we'll take a look at the reaction here in show motion, and you can see him immediately go to first and say, oh, yeah, he went around. Sure enough, he got the answer he was hoping for.
Corey Kluber digs in at the plate. Here's the first pitch to him. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
Now here's the pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. The pitch. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and no, he went around. It's strike 3. Indians go down 1-2-3. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Tony Cingrani makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number 3.
Tony Cingrani.
First pitch to him. Fouled straight back. Here's the pitch. And that misses downstairs for a ball, 1-1. Here's the 1-1. 1-2 now.
Yeah, that's just the same pitch, 3 times in a row. I guess he figures, why mess with success when you get it to 1-2?
Ooh. 1-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
Well, I can tell you from experience, there is nothing you hate more than a called strike three. I'd venture to say that 95% of the time the hitter doesn't agree with the call, but here, you'd better not have much to say because that was right there.
Here's Brandon Phillips. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one.
No strike.
The next pitch. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. But the throw will be well late. So a good play, but it's all for naught, as that'll be an infield single.
And the key to this is that he's running hard out of the batter's box all the way. You know, with some guys, it's not always the case, but he is really busting it down the line, and he's going to get rewarded with the infield hit.
Zach Cozart will stand in. He drew base on balls his first time. Now the first pitch. A double play ball to second. 4-6-3. It's a double play, and the inning is over. Reds go down quietly. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Michael Brantley will get a second shot now. He grounded out to start the ball game.
Michael Brantley.
Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Not much to shout about for either team here as we start the fourth inning, nothing, nothing.
Yeah, I think we kind of knew that pitching might take the upper hand here. Maybe not to this extent, but both guys have really thrown the ball well.
And a fastball runs a bit inside. He's down 2-0.
No strike.
Now the 2-0 home. And he'll lay the fastball in here to get the count back to 2-1.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, most of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
Oh, and he leaves the fastball up there. Mistake in location. He is going to pay for it dearly as that ball is sent over the wall. A home run. Solo shot to right center, number 25 for him on the year, as the Tribe move out in front 1-0.
And this is one of those guys that we consider to be part of that new breed of leadoff hitter. You know, it used to be that your leadoff guy was a guy that might hit 3 or 4 home runs a year. But nowadays, managers are realizing, hey, my leadoff guy is going to get more at-bats than anyone else in my lineup over the course of the season. So why not put a better hitter up there rather than just a punch and Judy guy? And that certainly worked out for him right here.
Now batting.
Here's Carlos Santana now.
Santana.
Standing in from the right side as he takes strike one. That home run a moment ago, estimated at 408 feet. Now here's the pitch. Right back to the bender again, and he's got him in an 0-2 hole now.
I think generous is the word here. That looked like it was 6 inches off the plate.
And now a pitch on the way. And he gets around on the fastball here as this is hit well out toward left field. Heisey has to retreat a bit, but he gets there for out number one.
Second base for number 22, Jason Kipnis.
Jason Kipnis will dig in with one in and one away. Now here's the first pitch. Fastball in there for a called strike.
And these guys already have one home run here in the inning, and now you get to the real power guys here. so you need to be careful.
One out, nobody on. And the pitch. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
And it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world here to mix in a take every now and again.
Pitch on the way. Now here's a ball hit hard on the ground to second. There to play it is Phillips. On to first, and there are two down.
The first baseman, number 33, Nick Swisher.
Nick Swisher will dig in. He singled his first time around. First pitch on the way. And this is hit hard on the ground towards short. Rowan Dovato will take care of him at first, and the side is retired. Indians are on the board first thanks to this solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 1-0 Cleveland. Joey Votto will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
First baseman, Joey Votto.
Now the first pitch. And that's in there for strike one.
It's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
Here it comes. Swing, hard hit ball to second. And the throw to first is in time, one gone. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you can see there, he's part of a flat-footed tie for the AL lead. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and that'll bring in the right fielder, Jay Bruce. Now here's the first pitch. And a cut fastball in there for a strike. It's 0-1. Now here's the pitch. And this is hit weakly in fair territory up the line. And good hustle to get over and tag him for the out.
And for a first baseman, if the most direct route is to just tag the guy, that's what you do. There's no sense in trying to throw it to your pitcher or your second baseman covering, especially if you don't have to.
Chris Heisey will try it again, set down on strikes his first time. First pitch coming. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. The pitch. Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. Here's the pitch. Now a little tapper here up the first baseline, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2.
Well, you take a swing at a pitch like that, you're lucky that you only got sawed off. He's going to have to go find himself another piece of lumber.
The next 0-2. Trying to get him to chase the cutter there, a ball and two strikes.
Yeah, after that last swing, I would have thought they'd go right back in, but that's actually not a bad location because I doubt he was looking for something out there.
And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Reds are down in order. It remains 1-0. Brandon Moss will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
The Indians, right fielder, Brandon Moss.
Here comes the pitch to Moss. And this ball's in the air and should be routine for Bruce in right field. One pitch, one away.
Well, any time you can retire this guy, that's good. Any time you can do it leading off an inning, that's great. And any time you can do it on one pitch, that's a full trifecta right there.
Yan Gomes will dig in, 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Here's the first offering. Swing and a miss on a pitch in the dirt, and it's strike one.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
Now here it comes. And this is fouled back and out of play. Now here's the pitch. Now a check swing, and he went around, says the home plate umpire. No appeal needed, and there are two away.
Oh, you gotta like the way he's throwing the ball right now. You get a one-pitch out to start the inning, and then you follow that up with a three-pitch strikeout. He's settling in nicely now.
Ryan Rayburn will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Here's the first offering. And a first pitch slider is right there for strike one. High strikes, probably not on the docket for places he wants to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's no secret. You've got to keep the ball down against a team like this. If you go up every once in a while with a fastball, you'll be fine. But you're not going to last too long if you make a habit of working up there with your secondary pitches.
Now the pitch. And a check swing here, but he holds up far too late as it's strike three and the inning is over. Nothing doing here this half. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Indians one and the Reds nothing. Todd Frazier will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
And now a pitch on the way. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. The 1-0 pitch. Hit on the ground to shortstop. And the Velas will throw on to first, and there's one gone. So another exceptional effort for him on the mound. He's got the shutout working here, as we'll show you the league ERA leaders. And as you can see there, he currently sits third in the AL in that category. Ryan Ludwig will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. First pitch coming. Starts him out with a sinker that's inside, 1-0. No runs, three hits, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. Hammered the other way to deep right field. Moss back to the track as he takes it for out number two. So still nothing against him on the scoreboard here in the fifth as we check out the league leaderboard for team ERA. And you can see that this staff currently leads the AL in that category. Brian Pena will try it again. He flew out his first time. First pitch coming. And that's inside for a ball, 1-0.
You know, maybe the most impressive thing about his performance so far, he's doing it all in a hitter's ballpark. Now, it's hard to come in here and pitch like this, but he's done a heck of a job.
Get it out of here. The 1-0. Fouled back. Here's the 1-1 pitch. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. The 1-2. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Here he comes again, 1-2. Now a swing and a ground ball, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Again, a 1-2. Now he drops a changeup on him. Strike three called, and a great pitch there to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Reds. They're down 1-0. Mike Aviles will get things started here in the top of inning number six.
Mike Aviles.
And here's the first pitch. 8-9-1 to start the inning as the first pitch misses for ball one. Well, for that man right there, only the one run allowed. How discouraging is that when you're pitching your heart out and you're just not getting the support?
Well, the good pitchers really don't let it get to them. They know that it cuts both ways. Sometimes you give up five runs and your guys score you eight. You just have to focus on holding up your end of the bargain.
Well hit high in the air and deep to center field. And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one.
Yeah, another good start to an inning for him here. He's really only made one bad pitch the entire game. That was the solo home run. Other than that, you can see there, not much to speak of at all.
Corey Kluber will get the call to bat for himself here with his guys up a run here in the sixth. First offering on the way. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. One run, two hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. 1-0 on the way. Oh, and he had him guessing there, and it's a ball and a strike.
Well, it's just game one of this series, but you almost have to wonder if they forgot to pack their offense when they got on the plane. It's been nowhere to be found so far.
Here comes the 1-1. And this is fouled straight back. Now here's the pitch. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. Here's another 1-2. And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning.
And you know, he really doesn't have to throw that changeup all that much for it to be an effective pitch. And you can see what his breakdown is so far.
Michael Brantley will stride in again, and you can bet he'd love to do again what he did back in the fourth. A solo home run here that's been the only long ball of the game so far. Here's the first pitch to him. Curveball looked at here for strike one. It appears safe to say now that that man right there has turned things around from his last start.
And it's a great sign, too, of exactly what you need to do. You have to have a short memory out there, but you're right. He's pitching with a lot more confidence in this outing.
Not the greatest at bat thus far as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now.
That's such a good pitch to get ahead. Lefty on lefty. It's a big looping curveball. Makes it very difficult for the hitter to try and time what's coming next.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here comes another 0-2. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three as they'll need to throw to first here. And the throw is in time. It's a strikeout and the play at first goes 2-3 for good measure as the inning is over. Down in order go the Tribe. But they hold a 1-0 lead. Tony Cingrani will lead it off here for the Reds, followed by Brandon Phillips waiting his turn on deck.
Tony Cingrani.
Now the first pitch. Pitch to the plate is a sinker for a called strike one. For that man right there, you need look back only to his last start to see a performance like the one he's shown here so far.
And well on his way to another great outing. And that's what you get when you mix your speeds and throw a lot of strikes.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
And you know what, guys? I have been really impressed so far. Not only has he used his fastball well, but he's also spotted it well. I mean, that is perfect location right on the knees.
And the pitch. Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
Yeah, doesn't look like much has changed here to start this inning either. That's 8 in a row now he's set down.
Brandon Phillips will dig in, 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. Now here's the first pitch. Sinker runs outside to start the at-bat, 1-0. And this will be fouled away. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a line drive. Foul. The 1-2 with one away. And he gets under this one and, in fact, breaks his bat as this one's popped up. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. Another 1-2 delivery. Now another pitch is hit foul and headed for the seats, so the count will stay put at 1-2. He'll try again, 1-2. Swing, and I believe this one is going to find the seats as well. It does, so quite a battle here as it remains 1-2. Here he comes again, 1-2. Lays off, 2-2 now.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
Sets the 2-2 pitch. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
And you know what, guys? This is a big league battle going on right now. Neither guy wanting to back down. No sign of weakness on either side.
3-2, here it is. Fastball too high, ball 4.
Wow, just a great at-bat right there. Simple as that. Patient, laid off some tough pitches. He was rewarded.
Zach Cozart will get another shot. He hit into a double play his last time. First pitch on the way. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1.
And that has been the comfort zone so far in this outing. He's just lived on that outside corner, and it's paid big dividends for him.
He's set, now the pitch. Swing and a ball pulled foul into the lower level and left. Runners on first with one down. From the belt, kicks and deals. Inside with the sinker, and that'll keep him honest at the plate.
Yeah, he's not trying to hit him, I don't think, but sometimes you need to keep guys honest up there. I think that's all he was trying to do there.
Here comes the 1-2. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number 2.
Can you take a look there at the line from our starter? I mean, basically, he's allowed 3 singles so far, and that's it. They haven't been able to mount any real opposition against him so far.
So it's a runner at first with 2 men out. And standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. first pitch to him. And they go right after him on the inside corner for strike one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Some stirring now in the Cleveland bullpen. They'll get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
A strike away now from getting through six shutout innings here, and that's no small feat against this lineup.
A runner on first with two away. Comes set, now the pitch. Ball swung on and hit high down the line in left, but it'll get back in among the crowd, so the count holds at 0-2. And now a pitch hit sharply on the ground. But this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. The 0-2 once more. Lined hard to center field. Brantley will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Reds leave one. They still trail 1-0. Back here at Great American Ballpark in Cincinnati. Seventh inning coming up with the Indians on top, but before we get any further, let's check out our game summary for the first six innings. Carlos Santana will come forward now to begin the seventh inning in what's been a very briskly played ball game here tonight.
That's what happens when you get two starters that are on top of their game. It's been great pitching, great defense, not a lot of base runners, and a very even game through six innings.
And now a right-hander's begun to loosen up in the Cincinnati bullpen. Now the first pitch. Grounded foul toward the coaching box at third. Here it comes. Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Pitch on the way. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven.
Boy, you talk about a guy getting himself in a groove. How about 10 in a row he's retired now? He's just making it look easy.
One out now for the Indians in their seventh. And standing in now, the power-hitting second baseman, Jason Kipnis. Now here's the first pitch. Oh, he shoots this one on into center field for a base hit.
And it had been a little while since they had any action on the base pass. He'd retired 10 in a row until that base hit right there. And now they're going to have to find a way to string a couple of these together.
Nick Swisher will dig in here. 1-for-2. He's singled and grounded out so far. Here's the first offering. In there, no balls and a strike. Yet again, another first pitch strike.
And it's a big reason of why he's having the success he is. You establish the count in your favor right away, and it just opens up the door to so many more options going forward.
Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Has a look, now the pitch. That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just watch it all the way in.
Now the 1-1. Outside. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And this is something we've seen a lot from him recently. He's worked his way into another good hitter's count.
Yeah, it's not unrelated either. When you're going good at the plate, usually means you're being selective and you're not getting yourself out. And when that happens, you'll find yourself in these kind of counts.
And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. Two-two pitch on the way. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
Now the question, do you send the guy on 3-2 with one out? You figure you're going to get something around the plate.
Here's the payoff pitch. Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
And you know, as a hitter, with the runner at first and one out, I think I'm going to see something down in the zone because I know they want me to hit into a double play. Instead, they go ahead and they challenge him up, and I don't think he was expecting that.
In now, Brandon Moss. Now a ball hit high in the air and deep down the line in left. And it, in fact, lands in the corner, foul. Two out with the man at first. Here comes the pitch to Moss. Right on that pitch that time as he wraps her field, a base hit. And with that, that'll push his hit streak to a modest 6 games. Yan Gomes will get his shot now with 2 on and 2 out here in inning number 7. First pitch coming. And he gets ahead 0-1.
And this is where the Indians just need one hit.
Pause, now the pitch. 0-2 now as a curveball drops in there for a strike.
Oh, and you know what? That might be the best curveball we've seen all night out of him. And he picked a good time to throw it.
He's ready now, the pitch. Now a swing and a bouncing ball toward the hole. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Indians strand a couple, but they're on top 1-0. Jay Bruce will step in now to lead off the home half of the 7th.
Right fielder, Jay Bruce.
First pitch coming. And a ball 1-0. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking and saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
Ready with the 1-0 now to Bruce. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
And down by a run, a leadoff walk would certainly help the cause. He's got to shrink that strike zone here and not chase anything that he shouldn't be swinging at.
Two-0 count, the pitch. That one's more like it, he says. Back to 2-1 now. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
And this pitch is hit foul off to the left and out of play, so the count goes to 2-2 now. Here he comes on 2-2. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. And it'll stay in the park as it hits high off the right field wall. Chris Heisey will stand in 0-2 thus far. First pitch coming. He's running towards second. Now a ball hit back up the middle, and he is in there. And a bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out.
I think these guys are pretty lucky just to get an out on this play.
You see, they try to start the double play at second base. That doesn't work out, and they're pretty fortunate that the relay throw is in time to at least get the out at first.
Here's Todd Frazier now, as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. He's ready. Now the pitch. Sinker, one ball, one strike.
And you know, he's been the beneficiary of most of the calls here tonight, but I think that's one that he thought he should have had.
Hits are now even at four apiece. Now the 1-1 pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. He's set. Now the pitch. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
Now batting.
He knows his job is to hang on to the lead for his team. But with a guy in scoring position, he's got to do something to come up big. Not a whole lot bigger situation to come up with a strikeout than right there. He's fired up about it, but he's still got some work to do right now. He's not out of this thing yet.
Into the box now, Ryan Ludwig. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. That man's team has definitely shot itself in the foot with all the strikeouts so far.
It seems like it's been a growing trend so far, but man.
Scoring position at second with two down. Here comes a 1-2. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. One left for Cincinnati. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Jonathan Broxton will be summoned from the bullpen now, as he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Batting in the sixth spot, number 51, Jonathan Broxton, now playing third base and batting in the ninth spot.
Ryan Rayburn will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time.
Leading off for the Indians, the left fielder number 11, Ryan Rayburn.
And there's no doubt Broxton really bringing it, and it's strike one.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
Now the pitch. Oh, he looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
That got in his kitchen big time right there.
Now the pitch. Fooled him a bit as this is hit high in the air towards right center and shallow. Phillips retreats to the outfield grass, and he has it for out number one. Pitching certainly has been on display in this one, and there's the evidence of it right there. 1-0 our score, as there are an awful lot of zeros on that line score to this point. Mike Aviles will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out, 0 for 2 thus far. And now the Reds are going to get the bullpen moving here, and it's a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. And here's the first pitch. And he puts a pretty good jolt into this one, high and deep to center. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out.
Well, this is why you have your speediest outfielder in center field. He doesn't have to be your best outfielder, but he's got to be able to track some things down. And this is why they've got him out there right now. What a brilliant play.
David Murphy will get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. A ball hit hard to the left side. Throw goes to Votto over at first. It's in time to retire the side. Indians go down 1-2-3. But they lead it 1-0. Mark Zepchinski is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
Mark Zepchinski.
Brian Pena will dig in. Took a cold third strike his last time.
Ryan Pena.
And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike. Nothing in one. Now here it comes. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. Here's the pitch. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one.
Yeah, in the eighth inning of a one-run game, it's always important to get that first out, put that offense on their back heels.
Devin Mesoraco will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Devin Mesoraco.
Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Now the 1-0. Grounded, foul. One one on the way. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
Oh, and he's sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee-high to ankle-high in a matter of about 5 feet.
Bases are empty, one man out. Now the 1-2. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch-outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
I'd say he's made a pretty good impression since coming on. Two batters, two strikeouts to start the inning.
Brandon Phillips will dig in now. 1-for-2 to this point. Brian Shaw will come on here looking to get the final out in the home half of inning number eight.
Brian Shaw.
Here's the first offering. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. And he powers the cut fastball by him that time, and he's in charge now, nothing in two.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning.
He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
Oh, he went for the knockout pitch that time, but a good eye, 1-2. Right-hander deals on 1-2. Now a swing and a ground ball headed for Aviles at shortstop. Throw on to first baseman Swisher, and the side is retired. Reds are down in order. It remains 1-0. Ramon Santiago has come into the ballgame now as he takes over as the new third baseman.
Third base, number 7.
Michael Brantley to get us started as they look for a little insurance here in the top of the ninth.
Hitting off for the Indians, center fielder, Michael Brantley.
And now pitch on the way. And that's lifted in the air out toward left. Heisey is there, and it's a picture-perfect beginning to the ninth inning for a pitcher. One pitch, one away.
Well, you know, he had the right idea up there, so at least you know he's thinking. He tried to go the other way with this ball, but he got under it just a little bit, and it's an easy play out there in left field.
Carlos Santana will stand in, trying to change his evil ways here. He is hitless in the ballgame so far. Johnny Chisenhall will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Driven nicely into the gap, and it's going to get down and should be extra bases. Around first is Chisenhall. He'll head for second now. And he'll pull in there with a one-out double.
Well, these guys know the deal from the offensive standpoint. They've got to add on to give their bullpen just a little more breathing room. And this is a good start as he jumps all over this one and drives it for two bases.
In is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis, as he'll swing and lift a foul ball off to the left and out of play. He's set, now the pitch. Swing and a liner toward right center. And he couldn't quite get high enough to pull that one down. It's into right center, a base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so they're runners at the corners now with one away.
And you know, once you see this ball get down in right center, I was thinking this is a run easy. But that's a nice play to get to it quickly and fire it back in. And that'll wind up forcing that runner to hold on at third base.
Here's the switch hitting Nick Swisher. Line hard, but foul. Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. Now the ball lined into left field. It's a base hit. And that could be a big insurance run here as that pushes the lead to two here in the top of the ninth.
That's a big run in a game like this. That makes it a two-run game now here in the top of the ninth. So now you give your guy a little extra breathing room out there in the bottom half. He'll appreciate it, believe me.
Sam LeCure will take over now with one away in the top of inning number nine.
Sam LeCure!
Brandon Moss will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. Here's the first pitch to him. Hard hit towards center. And that's in there. Base hit around third and being waved on home. And the run will score from second as now it's a 3-0 game.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see, and he was right on that one.
Yan Gomes will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Now the first pitch. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. A lot of movement that time. It's 0-2.
Oh, and you can tell by these first couple swings, he's not just looking to poke one through the right side of the infield. He's looking to put something into orbit.
From the belt, kicks and deals. You can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
You want to talk about throwing a fastball in a guy's kitchen? He came in, sat down, had a cup of coffee with him. You aren't going to tie a guy up any better than that.
Into the box, Ryan Rayburn, as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. From the stretch, this is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. From the belt, the pitch, and he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. So it's two runs on four base hits, no errors and a couple of men left on. 2-3-4 set to kick off the bottom of the ninth. The Indians on top, 3-0. Lonnie Chisenhall is going to go ahead and stay in the ballgame and play third down.
Number eight.
Zach Cozart will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth as they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
And whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
Cody Allen is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
Number 39, Cody Allen.
Yep. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one.
Well, you get the sense that what they need is one big hit from anybody in the lineup. If they could get one, it could get them right back in this game because right now they just seem out of it.
And the pitch. That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count. Boy, no messing around here in this ninth inning.
And that's a closer's mentality. They're not usually the best at setting guys up. They're going to come right at you with their best pitch, and that's usually a fastball.
Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
Just when you think you got a guy figured out, they start him out. Fastball, fastball. And break him down with an 0-2 bender. That didn't take too long.
In is Joey Votto now. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one.
Well, you know, if there's anybody in this lineup capable of getting a rally started, this is the guy right here.
One-oh pitch now. Fastball at 96 on the radar gun, and it's 1-1.
That thing's coming in there hot. 96 miles an hour.
Here's the 1-1 now to Votto. Opposite field to left. Rayburn is there, and quickly two are gone here, and it's not looking good for the home nine.
And in a two-game series, it's always nice to take game one because that ensures yourselves of no worse than a split. And they're just an out away from making that happen.
Jay Bruce is the last chance now with two out here in the ninth. First offering on the way. grounded foul toward the third base dugout. The pitch. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Ready now on 1-1. And this one misses to Bruce as he moves out in front. It's 2-1.
Yeah, that's a good spot to miss against a guy like this. He loves that pitch up in the zone. Most power hitters do, so that's not a bad idea to give him one above the letters.
Taken, called, strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight.
These guys would like to at least get someone on base here in this bottom of the ninth. Got to make them sweat a little.
Here comes a 2-2. Full count, 3-2.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking on the final out, so that's a tough pitch to lay off.
Here's the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. Foul. Here's the full count offering. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Slice down the left side, but foul. Now the 3-2 pitch. And this is fouled back and out of play. And now this will be the 10th pitch of the at-bat. Once again, a 3-2. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And that's going to put an end to this one. And the Indians will add one more to their winning streak as this ball game is over.
Another good job out of the bullpen here. That's nothing new. And that's save number 40 for him on the year.
Time for one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, I thought he really pitched well. He ran into a few problems here and there along the way, but aside from that, he was definitely a difference maker out there.
So that's a wrap here tonight. Eric Karros, Steve Lyons, Matt Vaskirjian, you've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Facebook at MLB The Show. The Indians win this one 3-0. Good night from Cincinnati.
Final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Cleveland Indians. 3 runs on 8 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Reds, the winning pitcher is Corey Kluber, his 19th win of the season.
Credit the save to Cody Allen, his 40th. The loss goes to Tony Cindrani. He falls to 6-10. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 34 minutes. A reminder that post-game Metro bus service is available to Anderson Township, Cobblewood Plaza, Kenwood, and Western Hills Plaza.
Good Thursday morning to you, Show Nation. Let's jump right into Wednesday's baseball action. In the AL Central, the Tribe paid visit to their in-state rivals, the Cincinnati Reds, at Great American Ballpark. The Indians came away with the win. The final was 3-0. Corey Kluber was victorious on the bump, earning himself his 19th win on the year. He is currently leading the American League in wins. The Rangers were on the south side of Chicago to take on the White Sox. And on the road, the Rangers stole the extra innings win. The score was 7-5. The San Diego Padres were in Minneapolis to take on the Twins in interleague play, and the Padres came away with the win in extra innings. The final score was 3-2. The Detroit Tigers were in the Big Apple to play the Yankees. The Tigers came away with the win, 9-0. Anibel Sanchez gave the bullpen a day off, turning in a complete game effort in the win. The Kansas City Royals were in Phoenix to take on the D-backs. The Royals came away with the win. The final was 5-4. Jason Vargas took his outing into the ninth inning and allowed only one unearned run before turning it over to the bullpen to secure the win for him. The Baltimore Orioles were in Canada to battle the Jays, and it was the Orioles who came away with the win. The score was 2-1. Chris Tillman started and pitched well enough to earn his sixth victory of the season. The Los Angeles Dodgers took the short trip down the I-5 freeway to take on the Angels, and the Dodgers collected the W. Final score was 6-2. Adrian Gonzalez collected 4 hits and led the charge offensively for the winning side. Dan Herron was impressive on the bump, earning his 12th victory of the season in the process. He is currently in the top 5 in the NL in wins. The Rays visited the Athletics in Oakland, and it was the Athletics who came out on top. Final score was 5-2. Jared Parker was impressive on the bump, earning his 12th victory of the season in the process. The Atlanta Braves played the Mariners in an interleague matchup in the Pacific Northwest, and Atlanta held on for the extra innings victory. The score was 6-5. Luis Avilan grabbed the win in relief, his 5th on the year. The New York Mets paid a visit to the nation's capital to play the Nats, and it was the Mets who came out on top. The score was 5-1. John Neese pitched into the ninth inning and collected the win on the mound. He only allowed 1 earned run. He is currently among the NL leaders in earned run average. The Astros took on the Phillies in Philadelphia in an interleague matchup, and it was the Phils who grabbed the victory. The final score was 3-2. Jimmy Rollins turned in a nice performance offensively with 3 base hits. Justin DeFreitas grabbed the win in relief, his 5th on the year. The Giants took on the Brew Crew in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and it was the Brewers who grabbed the win, the final 4-3. Tom Gorzolani grabbed the win in relief, his 5th on the year. The Miami Marlins matched up against the Buccos at PNC Park, and Miami prevailed in extra innings. The final score was 7-6. Christian Yelich was hot at the plate, collecting 3 hits in the game. He extended his hitting streak to a modest 6 straight games. The Red Sox were in St. Louis to take on the Cardinals. The Red Sox came away with the win, the final 6-4. Shane Victorino was a force at the plate, driving in 3 runs. He extended his hitting streak to a modest 6 straight games. Edward Mujica grabbed the win in relief, his 5th on the year. The Chicago Cubs took on the Rockies at Coors Field in Denver, and it was the boys from Northside Chicago who grabbed the W, 7-0. Edwin Jackson was the winning pitcher in this one, his 7th victory of the year. And that's what's going on around baseball heading into today's action. Join us again tomorrow for more updates from around Major League Baseball.